students of Hyderabad Central University. Present here. First of all, before I say any other word, I will salute the memory of Rohit Vimal. One of our country's martyrs. Martyrs in the tradition of Bhagat Singh. Rohit Vimal sacrificed his life. Some of you might have seen my Facebook page. What I have written about Rohit Vimal, that is on Chaman Lal JNU page. And the very first day, I put him, whatever way his life has gone, but that life is a sacrifice for the nation, sacrifice for the education system of this country, sacrifice to save our universities from fascist hands. So I salute, first of all, Rohit. Friends, I was supposed to speak today, first of all, inside the university, on Bhagat Singh, because I was approached by some of your young friends to mark 23rd March to speak on Bhagat Singh. But somehow I was already, you know, fixed for lecture in Baba Saheb Ambedkar Marathwada University, Aurangabad, where there is a Bhagat Singh Research Center. So we adjusted the date that maybe on 25th and 26th I can come and join. And I had a great desire, since the, you know, Occupy UGC movement and then the Rohit Vimal movement was going on during Rohit Vimal's lifetime, I wanted to come and express my solidarity with you as I am with my own, you know, university, JNU. If you remember, I have returned my MHRD award to protest against attack on me. I have written a very strong letter to the Vice Chancellor M. Jagdish Kumar and also to Manusmriti Irani that what you are doing, you are trying to destroy education in this country. So friends, this place is just like Freedom Square of JNU, where every day, like you, you have given the title Eklavya. They have been, you know, speaking for 4 hours almost, 5 o'clock to 9 o'clock. First, there was 1 month of series of talks on nation. What is the concept of nation? So the second series has just begun for the last 2-3 days. That is on Azadi. What is the concept of Azadi? The best scholars of the country, including of JNU and outside JNU, they are delivering fantastic lectures for 1 hour on these concepts. And I respect your this Eklavya meeting also in that very tradition. And since you have named Eklavya, I would like to come to Bhagat Singh. I want to, you know, I was actually supposed to speak first inside the campus, secondly in the evening here itself, and I was supposed to speak on the relation between fascism and so-called nationalism, kind of, you know, whatever is going on. But since the situation has changed in the last 2-3 days, so I will talk more about Bhagat Singh, about which I am supposed to speak tomorrow at Lamakan, also at 2 o'clock. Maybe a lot many of you will be there also. But to pay tribute to your Eklavya, you know, if you have heard revolutionary Punjabi poet Paash, who has been translated apart from Hindi in Telugu and Marathi also. Lot many Telugu knowing people will be knowing Paash poetry. And to pay tribute to your Eklavya meetings, I will recite you in Hindi, maybe lot many people will understand, the poem Dronacharya ke naam. You know, it was a Dronacharya, maybe you can give your own name to Dronacharya, whatever is going on, Appara or whosoever, your Dronacharya. So, to address to that poem, Dronacharya ke naam, Mere Gurudev, Usi vakt, Yadi aap, एक भील बच्चा समझ मेरा अंगूठा काट देते तो बात नहीं। उसी वक्त अगर मुझे भील बच्चा समझ मेरा अंगूठा काट देते तो बात दूसरी थी, लेकिन एनसीसी में बंदूक उठाने का नुक्ता तो आपने खुद बताया था कि अपने देश पर, लिसन, कि अपने देश पर जब कोई मुसीबत आन पड़े, और इसमें आप देश की बजाय यूनिवर्सिटी भी कह सकते हो, कि जब अपनी यूनिवर्सिटी पर कोई मुसीबत आन पड़े, दुश्मन को बनाकर टारगेट कैसे घोड़ा दबाया जाता है, दुश्मन को बनाकर टारगेट कैसे घोड़ा दबाया जाता है, आप ही ने सिखाया था। अब जब देश पर मुसीबत आ पड़ी और आप कह सकते हैं अब जब FTTI पुणे, JNU, HCU, इलाहाबाद यूनिवर्सिटी और तमाम देश की शिक्षण संस्थाओं पर मुसीबत आ पड़ी है, मेरे गुरुदेव खुद ही आप दुर्योधनों के संग जा मिले हो, खुद ही आप दुर्योधनों के संग जा मिले हो। हो सकता है आपकी यूनिवर्सिटी के द्रोणाचार्य दुर्योधनों के संग जा मिले हो। मैं ये कविता उनको भी संबोधित कर रहा हूँ। आई एम प्राउड ऑफ माई JNU फैकल्टी हु हैव स्टूड विद आवर JNU स्टूडेंट्स लाइक अ रॉक, एंड आई एक्सपेक्ट माई HCU कोलीग्स आल्सो, फैकल्टी कोलीग्स आल्सो, दैट दे शुड स्टैंड विद देयर स्टूडेंट्स लाइक अ रॉक एज आवर JNU फैकल्टी हैज स्टूड। आई हैव बीन प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ JNU टीचर एसोसिएशन, आई हैव रिटायर्ड 3 years अगो। आवर 83-year-old retired teacher, 80-year-old retired teacher, all have come out from their houses and come to a JNU to stand with their students. I also like to appeal, to make a request. Many of them I know also, many retired faculties of HCU, they have great status in the society also. Please come forward and stand with your students. They are the university. Stand with the HCU, save HCU, present and past faculty students, come forward. So, खुद ही आप दुर्योधन संग जा मिले हो, लेकिन अब आपका चक्रव्यूह कहीं भी कारगर ना होगा, अब आपका चक्रव्यूह कहीं भी कारगर ना होगा, और पहले वार में ही, in the first strike itself, हर घन चक्कर का 84 का चक्कर कट जाएगा, हर घन चक्कर का 84 का चक्कर कट जाएगा। हाँ, यदि आप छोटी उम्र में भील बच्चा समझकर मेरा अंगूठा काट देते तो बात दूसरी थी। अब ये जागे हुए एकलव्य हैं, अब ये अंगूठा कटे एकलव्य भील बच्चे नहीं हैं। आई सैल्यूट जागे हुए एकलव्य। और एक आपके पहले स्टूडेंट बोल रहे थे, बहुत ही अच्छी तरह से बोल रहे थे, और उसके ऊपर भी पाश ने एक बड़ी जबरदस्त पोइम लिखी है जो आपके ऊपर भी लागू होती है, और मैं चाहता हूं कि मैं आपको वो पोइम भी सुना ही दूं। जो जुल्म आंध्र प्रदेश या तेलंगाना की पुलिस या दिल्ली की पुलिस या पंजाब की पुलिस करती है, न सिर्फ विद्यार्थियों पे, आदिवासियों पे, दलितों पे, मजदूरों पे, किसानों पे, हर जनतांत्रिक आंदोलन पे, हर डेमोक्रेटिक मूवमेंट पे, वो पुलिस ब्रिटिश कॉलोनियल पुलिस से भी गई गुजरी पुलिस। ब्रिटिश कॉलोनियल पुलिस भी इतना जुल्म नहीं कर सकती थी जितना जुल्म हमारे सो कॉल्ड आजाद मुल्क की पुलिस जो है हमारे तमाम जनतांत्रिक लोगों पे करती है। तो घास करता एक है, ग्रास, घास, मैं घास हूं, मैं आपके हर किए दिए पर उगाऊंगा, मैं घास हूं, मैं आपके हर किए धरे पर उगाऊंगा। बम फेंक दो चाहे विश्व देले पर, बना दो हॉस्टल मलबे के ढेर, जो HCU में और JNU में हो रहा है उसी को लेके लिखा है ये 1970-71 की लिखी हुई पोएम, जब पंजाब के स्टूडेंट्स पर जुल्म हो रहा था पंजाब की पुलिस के द्वारा, उस वक्त की पोइम है ये। बम फेंक दो चाहे विश्वविद्यालय पर, बना दो हॉस्टल मलबे के ढेर, सुहागा फिरा दो भले ही हमारी झोपड़ियों पर, मुझे क्या करोगे, मुझे क्या करोगे? मैं तो घास हूं, हर चीज ढक लूंगा, हर ढेर पर उगाऊंगा। भंगे को ढेर कर दो। ये शहीद भगत सिंह का पैतृक गांव है, ये कुछ नाव है कस्बों के। संगरूर को मिटा डालो, धूल में मिटा दो लुधियाना का जिला। मेरी हरियाली अपना काम करेगी, 2 साल 10 साल बाद सवारियां फिर किसी कंडक्टर से पूछेंगी ये कौन सी जगह है, मुझे बरनाला उतार देना, जहां हरे घास का जंगल है। मैं घास हूं, मैं अपना काम करूंगा, मैं आपके हर किए धरे पर उगाऊंगा। अवर जनरेशन, यंगर जनरेशन इज लाइक ए ग्रास, यू कैन नॉट क्रश इट बाई ऑपरेशन, बाई सुप्रेशन, बाई बॉम्ब्स, बाई पिस्टल्स, बाई शूटिंग्स, बाई बीटिंग्स। सो फ्रेंड्स, लेट मी नाउ कम टू द बेसिक थिंग दैट यू यंग पीपल एंड आई से विद असर्शन, टुमारो ऑल द राइट विंग, मे बी एबीवीपी, मे बी आरएसएस पीपल विल बी अटैकिंग मी लाइक एनीथिंग व्हेन आई एम गोइंग टू से दिस दैट रोहित वेमुल्ला हैज फॉलोड द पाथ ऑफ शहीद भगत सिंह। He was a true follower of Dr. Ambedkar and Shahid Bhagat Singh. And he has sacrificed his life for this nation, for this university system, for this education system, just in the tradition of Bhagat Singh. So, I know people will attack me by comparing Rohit Vemmulla to Bhagat Singh. They will say, oh, you are talking, making Rohit Vemmulla Bhagat Singh. You are Deshdrohi, you are anti-national, you are this, you are that. But I can tell you, my dear friends, Bhagat Singh would have been proud of Rohit Vemmulla. Bhagat Singh would have been proud of Rohit Vemmulla. Because whenever Bhagat Singh has told one thing very clearly, we are not fighting against color, we are not fighting against British colonialism only. We are fighting against a system. It makes no difference that in place of Lord Reading, if Sir Purushottam Das Thakkar sits in the chair of Viceroy, or in place of Lord Irwin, Sir Tej Bahadur Sapru sits. Till the time, exploitation of one man by the other man doesn't finish off. Till that time, our war for liberation, our fight for freedom will not end. We are not fighting just for changing the color of the power from white hands to brown hands. Our fight is for the workers of this country, peasants of this country, students of this country, youth of this country, women of this country. All those people who work, who do labor, and our fight is against whether they are whites, whether they are browns, who are the corporate worlds, capitalist world, feudal worlds, our fight is against them. And it will continue whether it's against people are holding power are brown or people are holding power long ago was white. Now our brown people are working as the remote of white people sitting in Washington, sitting in America. So they are America's remote. They are selling the country to American imperialism, like, you know, British colonialism was holding the power in this country directly, indirectly. It's US imperialism who is holding the power by remote controlling these all great Desh Bhagats, great nationals who are killing people, who are beating up people by the phony kind of nationalism, those people who have never sacrificed a life, who have never gone to jail, who had no role in the freedom of this country, they are telling young people who are going on the path of Bhagat Singh to liberate the people of this country, which are still suffering from the exploitation and the oppression of this brown sahibs, they tell them that they are Deshdrohis. You are Deshdrohis. These are the real Deshdrohis who are sitting in the power in Delhi and other places, who are telling real patriots, real nationalists, you are the real nationalists. You are the real patriots of this country. They are the real, you know, traitors of this country. They are the real Deshdrohis of this. They are the anti-nationals of this country who have acquired power by deceiving people. And after deceiving people, they are killing people. They are killing the universities. They are killing the young people. So, dear young friend, you are doing a great service to the nation. You are doing the great service to the nation. I salute your struggle. Yours is the real struggle. You are the real Indians. They are the phony, fake Indians, you know, remote controlled by white bosses in America. So they cannot talk about you as anti-national or like anything. So friends, carry on with your struggle. And by carrying on your struggle, you are paying the real tributes on 23rd March, Martyrdom Day of Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev, Rajguru, and also Rohit Vemmulla. You are paying real tributes by struggling. Struggle is the key to liberate not only society, not only nation, but your own self. By participating in struggle, you are acquiring your own personality. You are liberating yourself. Your horizon is getting broadened. You know what the liberation means. How Che Guevara fought, how Bhagat Singh fought. You are knowing all these things. You are becoming real Ekalavya. This is the real learning. Learning through struggle is the best learning. Learning through books is also good learning. But learning through struggle is the best learning, that I can assure you, although I teach books and get paid for that, or was paid for that, but I know, learning through struggle cannot, you know, match learning through books. Learning through struggles is always has a higher status. As much you learn through struggles, that much, in fact, the knowledge given in the books is also learned by participating in this. You might be reading about Dr. Ambedkar, you admire Dr. Ambedkar. You admire Periyar. You admire Bhagat Singh. Many of you admire Marx, Lenin, Che Guevara. By reading their books, that also affects you. That affects your consciousness. You become more aware, you become more conscious. But when you practice their ideas in life, through participating in the struggles, you really appropriate it. Appropriating Bhagat Singh, appropriating Che Guevara, appropriating Periyar, appropriating Ambedkar, the best way to appropriate them is to fight for those ideas which they have written in the books. But you know, all know that how just 20th March was the anniversary of Mahar struggle. Mahar struggle launched by Dr. Ambedkar. Bhagat Singh struggle. So these are the struggles which you have to, you know, participating and following their tradition. I think this was the day I understand that you have gone through great suffering in the last 3 years. Great suffering. And let me mention you, there one essay by Bhagat Singh. He wrote in 1923, six of our great freedom fighters, Babar Akalis, militant revolutionary youth, they were hanged by British colonialists. The day they were hanged, that was a holy day, the festival of holy, the festival of colors. And Bhagat Singh wrote an article, Holi ke din rakt ke chhinte. On the day of holy festival, British colonialism has played holy, has played colors with the blood of our patriots, with the blood of our young, you know, martyrs. I feel ashamed. I hang my head in shame being in this country that on 23rd March, which was incidentally, was holy day, festival of colors, as well as martyrdom of Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev and Rajguru, who gave their life for the nation. On that 23rd March, our young students of Hyderabad Central University, on this pious day, their blood was sprinkled by this Hyderabad police. Shame on this university administration. Shame on this police of this state, who on the pious day of Bhagat Singh's martyrdom day or on holy day sprinkles the blood of Uday Bhan, the young boy who was cooking for his hungry police. What you treat on 23rd March to Uday Bhan? Shame on you. Shame on this kind of colonial history. Shame on this administration who is looking at the blood being sprinkled of their students. If any person other than this Dronacharya of university had a human heart, had a human sensitivity, he would have. You know, chullu bhar pani mein doob marna hai. Chullu bhar pani mein doob marta. Apne university ke students ki ye halat. Kam se kam itna to karta. Ki main yahan mere student mujhe nahi chahte. I don't want to sit on that chair. I don't want to sit on that chair where my students do not love me, where my students do not respect me. But power-hungry man, without any sensitivity, without any conscience, on the pious day of holy, is playing holy with the blood of his own students. Shame on such administration. Shame. So, dear young students, I am really happy that I have come between you. And at the time when you are undergoing very real suffering, let me tell you what I know about JNU. Neither Kanhaiya Kumar nor even the most vilified Umar Khalid and Anirban Biswas were subjected to physical torture in prison. They were not. They were abused. They were treated harshly, badly, but they were not subjected to physical torture. But I have heard that even the faculty members of this university and the students of this university have been subjected to physical torture. Shame on such people who treat in police custody students and faculty in such way. When Kanhaiya Kumar was beaten inside the court, I had written what letter I wrote to Vice Chancellor, that LA Vice Chancellor, it was your duty. He was an elected president of JNU student, whatever charges he might be facing. But as Vice Chancellor, it was your duty when you heard about it, that he has been mistreated by the black-coated goons inside the court. You should have taken dean of the university, supervisor of that student, to police station to look for him. And he has not performed. But shameless people do not perform. Same way, if teachers of this university have been beaten, it's shame on the Vice Chancellor of this university if he has not protested that my teachers have been beaten up in the police station. You are throwing false cases on them. That apart, But you are not following even the law of the land. It is the law of the land that in the custody of police, no accused can be touched. No accused can be physically tortured. They have signed the UN Convention. These bloody, khooni log jo Delhi mein baithe hain, UN mein jaake sign karte hain, ki hum human rights ko mante hain. Aur Hindustan mein, apne yahan police stationon mein, kis kis tarah se torture karte hain. किस किस तरह से सोनी सोनी को टॉर्चर किया छत्तीसगढ़ में और दूसरे लोगों को और किस तरह से हैदराबाद सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटी के स्टूडेंट्स को और टीचर्स को फिजिकल टॉर्चर किया है पुलिस स्टेशन में. शेम शेम एंड पुलिस शुड पीपल शुड बफ एंड यू हैव ए ड्यूटी टू बफ. थैंक यू वेरी मच माई डियर यंग स्टूडेंट.
Dear friends.